O come Emmanuel, and ransom.
Praise God, and welcome to another exciting day on the Voice of Resurrection devotional. We are rounding up this week on our third week studying Emmanuel. It's been so powerful and enriching, and beloved, and I pray that you should go back and watch some of the past episodes, so that the Holy Spirit will challenge where you are in the Lord, challenge your heart, wake you up, cause you to begin to seek the Lord, His abiding presence to rest with you. In other words, you've been accustomed to having irritations and anger and depression and fear. Now it is time for Emmanuel, the abiding presence of God, to invade your life and cause miracles to happen. One of the things that happened to me when God asked me to start my ministry and gave me this covenant, I discovered a totally different thing. Before then, you know, we fast and pray and we get anointed, but then it was for that time. But when He gave me this covenant, this stuff is on me all the time. As I say it, it works even when I don't work. It comes on me, it's a quickening spirit, it's a resurrection anointing. And as time has passed, I've gotten more confident and more comfortable in my skin, that is, in that grace, in that anointing. That's what Emmanuel is. When you understand God's love for you and receive Him in totality, you will see an abiding presence, Emmanuel, God with you, talking to you, ministering to you, guiding you, developing you, healing you, restoring you. I pray that you will go for Emmanuel this Christmas season. Let that be your gift. God wants to bless you with a gift this season. Receive Emmanuel in Jesus' name. Amen. Once again, 1 Timothy 3:16, and without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. God was manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels. Okay, that's where we left off yesterday. Now, preached unto the Gentiles, believed on in the world, received up into glory. Yes, that's our job, to go forth and preach to the Gentiles this word, that God has come down in human flesh, in Jesus Christ, to save the world, to redeem us from our false religions, and redeem us from our iniquities, redeem us from everything Satan has gotten us into. And He says He is believed on in the world, and then He's been received into glory. I love what the angels said to the disciples or the apostles. As they were standing there looking into glory, and the angel said to them, "Why gaze ye into the skies, unto the heavens?" He said, this same Jesus will come back to earth as you have seen Him go. This same Jesus, this same Emmanuel. Yeah, we don't need to wonder. Beloved, He's coming every day. Some people left the earth today. Some people will leave tomorrow. Some people will leave the next day. And others are coming. Whether He comes in the sky for you or He comes personally, be ready to go with Him. He is received into glory and He's coming again. Hallelujah. Let me read once again John 14, verse 16 through 18. I want to squeeze this in before we leave today. This is the New Living Translation of a scripture we already dealt with. It says, "And I will ask the Father, and He will give you another advocate, who will never leave you." You see, Emmanuel is abiding in your life by the Holy Spirit. He is the Holy Spirit who leads into all truth. The world cannot receive Him because it isn't looking for Him and doesn't recognize Him. But you know Him because He lives with you now and later will be in you. No, I will not abandon you as orphans. I will come to you. Wow, Emmanuel, I won't leave you fatherless. Emmanuel, I will be there. I will never. Come on, let me rush to Hebrews 13. verse 5. He said, let your conversation be without covetousness. That's the message for Christmas. Let your life, you know, be without covetousness. Don't get into buying and giving and going through all these changes. As I said 2 days ago, it is Jesus who should receive all the Christmas gifts. All this billions spent in the shops should come to the house of God for the church to take back their responsibility in taking care of the poor and raising of orphans and taking care of widows. All that money belongs to the church. The government needs to get out. The government and their welfare program needs to get out of the way. The money should come back to the church that we may do the work of the kingdom. That's the way it is. The government is an imposter. The government is the leaven of Herod. They need to get out of the way. The people should, you all should come back to church. Bring the money back to the church so we can take care of the poor and take care of the fatherless and the widows and raise them for God. America will change, beloved. The government needs to get out of the way. Stop talking about what the government is doing for you. No, you should get your help from the Lord our God and from the church. The money should come back to the church, beloved. That's the word of God. Beware of the leaven of Herod. And some of you preachers are preaching this stuff, and you will give account when you get before the Lord. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. For he has said, I will never leave thee, nor forsake thee, so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, I will not fear what man shall do unto me. What a wonderful way to end it this week. We love you. Next week is Christmas. We'll be talking about this wonderful story all over again. We love you. May God bless you. We see you next week, Pastor Chica. Bye-bye.